That song hits way freaking too close to home in some ways. That's one of the risks I take doing this, especially traditional country, but songs to me that fit that feel. Welcome to the channel, everybody. Rockin' a Country. I'm Don. Hope things are going well for you. I'm doing a song for my Country Heart series. And many of you probably know Meatloaf. Died a couple of weeks ago. He passed away by the time you see this. And I, you know, for quite a while, I've kind of wanted to do a song by him, but I just never really thought to do it in earnest. And now I want to do it. So I picked one. Two out of three ain't bad. And it's a review. I don't rate my Country Heart series songs, but I just wanted to do it. I haven't heard this song in quite a while, but I had this album and I loved, I think, every song on the album, which is rare. Usually there's one or two dogs on every album, you know, personal taste. I think I liked every song on this album. All right, here we go. This hits me like a lot of country songs do.
Baby, we can talk all night, but that ain't getting us nowhere. I told you everything I possibly can. There's nothing left inside of me. And maybe you can cry.
You know, the thought just struck me listening to this. That's what happens, you know, when I do reactions. I hear songs differently, especially as an older man versus when I was a younger teenager when I got this album. You know, meanings, they could take on new meanings. But now I'm wondering, was she the one saying to him? And he's just recounting. Now, I mean, I'm going to go with my original understanding of it, that this is just the way he's feeling. But I want you, I need you, but there's no way I'm going to love you. That's a very odd thought. And there's a depth to it. I'm still trying to figure that out.
You'll never find your goal on a sandy. Ah!
Is this that the cycle is continuing? Like, this woman that he loved back in the day. I don't think it's the same woman that the song started with, the one he's in the relationship now that's gone wrong. I wonder if this is just the woman he loved initially told him she loved him, wanted him, but there's no way she's going to love him. Then he gets in another relationship later, and then he repeats that to this new woman. Like, that dynamic played out with her. Huh. Alrighty then, my head is twisted. Not there.
I want you.
I want you.
That song hits way freaking too close to home in some ways. That's one of the risks I take doing this, especially traditional country, but songs to me that fit that feel, even though this didn't have all the elements of traditional country, the lyrics and the feel, the overall oomph hits me deep like that. And there's a risk because some of these songs hit the nail on the head of elements that I've lived in my life, just like they do for you guys. That's partly why we like songs. Now, other songs are just fun, 99 Love Balloons, and we're all happy. But other ones are just, they draw us in, and maybe they're revelatory in ways. We get some new understanding, or we don't feel so alone because somebody else is writing about a similar dynamic. And the human psyche is what it is, but I'm going to leave that be at this point. Some songs get thrown in, up in the air and then back into the reassessment bin, and this one now is doing that. Huh. So yeah, I'm curious about your thoughts. I know a lot of you folks know this song because Meatloaf just burst on the scene, and the guy was just such a consummate performer, and he gave so much to the audience, and the songs are so different and theatrical and real in this case. So, all right, guys, that's going in the Country Heart Series playlist. And have a great day. See you on another video. Keep rocking the country and songs with a country heart.